Hi, welcome back everyone. Today let us see few eagle eye spotters. Case 1. Patient presented with headache, axial flare image. The most important thing which we should not miss before reporting any MRI is always look for the phloids. Here you can see loss of phloid in the superior sagittal sinus anteriorly as well as posteriorly, which is suggestive of superior sagittal sinus thrombosis, and this is a proven case of superior sagittal sinus venous sinus thrombosis. Case 2, again a classic one, but most of the times it might be subtle, that is the hyperdense right lentiform nucleus and caudate nucleus. You can see the normal density of the left caudate nucleus and lentiform nucleus. This is a classic case of non-ketotic hyperosmolar coma or hemichorea hemibalismus syndrome, and this is an incidental meningioma which was seen in this patient. Another classic one, but there is a both cause and finding in this diagnosis, is a xylolith in the left parotid duct. You can see the right parotid gland and compare it with the left parotid gland. It is enlarged in size. There is a xylolith. You can see the subcutaneous fat standing as well. And this is a left acute parotitis due to xylolithiasis in the parotid duct. Always look for the, once the lesion is visible, we need to assess a lot of things. In this image, it speaks a lot. Always look, this is the lesion in the head of the pancreas. You can see it's invading the confluence of the superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein, and you can see the liver lesions as well. And always we need to be careful assessing the pancreatic carcinoma with the fat planes, with the adjacent stomach, as well as IVC, portal vein, celiac trunk and adjacent vessels as well as liver, because it determines the operability status of pancreatic carcinoma. So this is a case of pancreatic carcinoma with hepatic metastasis and portal vein thrombosis. A classic one, sometimes it might be missed if the patient is mildly symptomatic, like such mild abdominal pain. You can see a classic target sign. You can see the bowel into bowel appearance. This is the outside part of the bowel. This is the inside part of the adjacent bowel, which is protruded into it with adjacent mesenteric fat and few vessels. So this is a classic case of ileocecal into susception. Thank you all.